Now, here we are checking about the Boolean literals as well as the character literals. Now, as you can see, the Boolean variables can only take two values, that is true and false. Okay. Now, for example, let us say I create a variable Boolean A is equal to true. Now, this is a valid thing because obviously Boolean variable can take a true value. Or if I say Boolean B is equal to false, that is also valid because Boolean variable can take a false value. But if I try to say Boolean C is equal to inverted commas true. Now, because of these inverted commas, now this is not a Boolean value, this is a string. So, Boolean variables cannot take a string as input, so this is not valid. If I try to do Boolean D is equal to 0, that is also not valid, and Boolean E is equal to 1, that is also not valid. What happens is, in the people who are coming from the background of C programming language, in C language, whenever I'm writing 0, that means false, and whenever I'm writing 1, that means true. So, let me just show it to you with an example. In C programming language, the students who have studied C programming before, if I write integer A is equal to 5 less than 6, if I write integer B is equal to 6 less than 5, if 0, there is some statements, maybe printf hi, and we can also do if 1, we can say printf bye. So in C programming language, whenever the result of an expression is false, here for example the result of the expression is true, so this is going to return 1 into A, so 1 will be stored in A, and this result of this expression is false, therefore 0 will be stored in B. So in C language, 0 means true, 0 means false, and 1 means true. Again, in any expression, 0 means false, this means false, and this means true, but this is not valid in case of Java. In Java, for true and false, we use a separate notations, that is true and false. We cannot use 0 and 1. So, Boolean variables can only take the value true and false. They cannot take 0 and 1 as the values. So, the next is character literals. Obviously, the character literals, as you know, what are characters? So, characters are a single, you know, the unit or which is representing symbols. Okay. So, like for example, in Java programming language, characters are represented by Unicode. So, we can have so many symbols, so many different kinds of symbols. A character can represent a Chinese Mandarin language, or it can represent Hindi language, or any, I mean, so many languages are there in the world. And for every language, a character is having a symbol. Right? So, here we can specify a character with the help of a single code. There are four ways how you can define a character literal. So, single quote, second is character literal as an integral literal, that is like an integer number. Third is Unicode representation, and the fourth is escape sequence. Let me show you two with an example. So, as you can see here in this example, the first is character CH is equal to single quotation A. Now, this is actually valid because here single quotation A means it is a Unicode character, and the character that is stored is small a. Now, I can also give values which are starting with 0, that is integer number starting with 0 or 0x. So, these characters also take the integer numbers which are represented in octal format, which are represented in hexadecimal format, as well as which are represented in binary format. So, here for example, the very first number that we are using here, this number is an octal number. So, we are going to convert this octal number into a decimal number, so that can be written as 65 base 8. You have to convert this number in decimal numbers, which will be 5 plus 48, which can be represented as 53. So, for this decimal number, we are going to have an equivalent Unicode symbol, and that equivalent Unicode symbol will be stored in this character A. Okay, so this is also a valid representation. If I am doing character CH3 is equal to 65. Now, this 65 is actually representing the character which is capital A. So, capital A will be stored in CH3. If I am doing character CH4 is equal to 0x32. So, 0x, because of 0x, this means that this 32 number is a hexadecimal number. So, convert this 32 number, hexadecimal number, into a decimal number, which is going to be 50. Now, for this 50, we will be having an equivalent Unicode representation. This is a 50 as a decimal number. We will be having an equivalent Unicode representation. And that representation is going to be printed in this case. See, whatever programs I am writing, whenever you are studying for my videos, just try and execute those programs, you will get to know whatever I'm teaching, how this is working in your compiler, because that way you'll get some experience. So if I'm writing character ch is equal to slash u0061, actually this is a Unicode representation for small a. So small a will be stored in ch5, and this is also correct. If I'm writing char ch6 is equal to slash n, actually this slash n, this one slash n, this is a escape character. So we can also store escape character in the characters. So this is also correct. If I take character ch is equal to slash d, this is not correct because this is not a valid escape character. So here you can see I've already given you the list of possible escape characters. And when I'm saying character ch8 is equal to slash u Anushka, now this is not a valid representation. The reason is this is not a valid Unicode string, right? Next is character ch9 is equal to 65129. Now this is a valid character. The reason is a characters that we have, for example, characters that we have, these characters are of 2 bytes. 2 byte means the minimum number that they can store is 0 and the maximum number that they can store is 2 raised to power 16 minus 1. Now whatever the decimal number that we are giving, if the decimal number is between this range, between 0 to 2 raised to power 16 minus 1, then that decimal number considered as a valid number. So this is correct. But if you see this one, this is not correct because the decimal number that we are giving here, that is not between 0 to 2 raised to power 16 minus 1. So this is not a valid representation. Okay. So you can see out of these which is valid and which is not valid. A part of this, there's a list of possible escape characters also. We have slash b that is used for backslash, slash n is used for next new line, slash r is used for carriage return, that is enter, slash if you slash and inverted commas. So whenever you want to use inverted commas, then you can use slash inverted double inverted commas. You can also use single inverted commas. You can also use backslash. And a part of this, you can also use form field and you can also use the horizontal tab. So these are all the escape characters that we can use. If you are going to use anything apart of these escape characters, if you want to give slash z, now slash z is not a valid escape character, so this is not going to be correct. Okay, so we have a set of valid escape characters. You can also search these kind of Unicode representation over Google. So take this as an assignment. Do a simple Google search. What are the possible representation of the, what are the possible Unicode representations like this, and that can be valid for your code. Okay, so I hope that you have an idea about this character literals also. So we have one more type of literal that is left, that is called as a string literal. So let me just rub it up and I'll come back very quickly to represent the string literals. Okay.